Let's see. Let's get your groove on, Nick.
Not that we're good at that. If I'm holding a baby, I can do it. I have to pretend. I have my little character here. Where is he?
It's like you sing a lullaby. It's a trumpety lullaby.
My little prop.
There you go.
That's natural.
Give me the slide today.
Oh, well, back to the old drawing board.
Laser.
He's my favorite character, I think, of all the... of the Warner Brothers canon, the Warner Brothers batches, all the Mel Blanc voices,
all the fun people, right?
Yeah.
All the fun people. Speaking of fun people, we got a bunch of fun people in the chat room. Yeah. Hello and good morning to everybody in the chat room. Check you guys out. Thanks for hanging out with us.
Mm-hmm. As Trish is noting, it's dancing time. Oh, all right. Enough dancing. Back to the serious stuff.
Wednesday morning, it's a good morning for a dance, we always say.
Good times. And if those trumpets don't stick in your brain for the rest of the day, you've got problems, I think. You know. Very cool.
Of course we do.
Yeah, we have always got problems. What the heck?
Who's our guest today, Chris?
Our guest today is Nick Floro, who hasn't actually ever joined us yet. Which is, anyway, you've been on the list for a long time. We've been looking forward to getting you in here and chat a bit today. Nick, for the folks who haven't met you before, I don't know where you're coming from. Give us your little bio, explain what you do, the kinds of things you're all about.
Hi, everybody. I'm outside of Philadelphia in Bucks County, where I actually grew up and live around the corner from my parents' house. I am a learning architect, which basically means I help stakeholders understand technology and figure out how to connect the pieces to create learning experiences. One of the fun aspects of getting to play with all these toys is I get to talk about them, which I really enjoy, and get to experiment. So the spouse had to get permission to get the latest toys and technology. But once I get past that little hoop, we get to dance and figure out all this neat stuff and how to connect it all to make cooler stuff.
The requirement to present your argument for the new thing is something that I think many people experience. So, Christopher Yellen is saying, hi, Nick, waving from down the street in Downington.
Ah, it's so cool. It's so funny. We go into these virtual worlds and like we meet our neighbors. And like, wait, what?
But it's safer this way. We don't have to wear masks and we're not breathing each other's germs in. So, yeah. Good.
Always at the ready. Yeah. As a quick back in the day aside, when I was at the Guild, I asked Nick to be our media guy to do this kind of stuff on the stages back in the day, the early Devlearn days. He was our stage director guy on the media stage. Is that what we called it? Or I don't know.
Yes. I still have a screen grab somewhere. But I still get called, hey, you're that media guy. I'm like, yes, that's me.
Yeah, it's perfect. So those always were very well attended when you ran those. You did a fantastic job. And I think, you know, people got to know you as the media tools, tips, app guy, all that fun stuff. So we know you've got some good things in your pocket today for us, right?
Yes, lots of new toys. Some are free, some are inexpensive, but as part of the challenge of finding the right pieces, we are always looking for things that we can plug in to help make our tools better.
Mm-hmm. Very cool. Well, and people certainly like free, and then they like cheap almost as much as free, but free they love. So
almost free,
nearly free. Cool. So let's maybe get started with something here to get us underway.
Yeah, so the first program is called OBS Studio. And you go to obsproject.com and it allows you to download for your Mac or Windows computer basically a studio in a box. And what it does is allows you to use your computer, your built-in camera, and allows you to basically key yourself out if you've got a green screen or a plain wall and put yourself as somewhere on the screen, but you can record in real time. And what's great about the product is that it's free, but it also allows you to compress in real time. So if you want to plug that into your favorite tool or upload it to a website, you're able to do that in minutes rather than having to go to another compression tool. So it makes life a lot easier. I think you guys would both love it because it also lets you plug in multiple cameras or multiple devices. So you can use your keyboard or a switching device to automatically pull up PowerPoint, Keynote, whatever program you want to pop up and bring in another stream to help key those different elements together.
It's nice. I think most people use it for streaming, Twitch. Like to do the lower thirds and to add special effects and all that kind of stuff. But one of the cool things that you can do is just pre-produce your whole show kind of live. You don't even have to stream it. Just produce whatever it is you're doing with all those special effects just locally. And then you've got it. You don't have to do any editing at the end or anything like that. Everything is done in one shot, then you export it and you upload it and you're good to go.
I like J-Rock's description. It's like a video version of an audio mixing board.
Yes.
Cool.
One of the really cool programs, we'll see if I can lift it up. There's another program by a company called Elgato, ELGATO.com. And they have a free program that you can use on your iOS or Android device called Stream Deck. And they also sell a physical hardware product. We'll see if I can pull it up here. And what this does, it allows you to map any key or macro to this device. And the software is really amazing because you can drag and drop and pick a little icon. Makes it really easy. But they sell three different flavors. But you can actually download the software for free and pop it into your phone or your tablet and use that as a device to test it out and see if you'll actually use it. So you can actually get started playing for nothing, which is great.
Nice. And how much is that little hardware gadget that you have there?
The hardware gadget will range from $100 to $250. What's happened right now because of our situation is that all the video media lighting things have like skyrocketed. So if you have a couple in stock, it's a good time to sell them. You know, like a 50% markup. It's like, what?
Yeah. I went looking for one of my old C920s and because I know I've got one in a box somewhere. And I thought just as a joke, I'd put it up on eBay or something for like $999 and start the bidding.
Bidding wars.
See what happens, because everything was sold out within the first 2 weeks of the entire country shutting down. Everything was gone.
Heather's asking in the questions about those two tools, can you add closed captions with them?
Great question. Neither one of those will do that automatically or dynamically. It's coming. You can feed that in as a separate stream, like YouTube will automatically do it for you, and Google, Amazon, Microsoft, all of their server-based technologies are starting to offer APIs to help stream that in. But I haven't seen that magic combination where I can hit that little key and pull it up in real time. I guess
the solution might be, instead of just doing it locally to produce your video, you could do that and stream it to YouTube in order to get that.
Yes. And you can actually feed that stream like to Crowdcast, the platform we're using today, as well as YouTube in real time, or you can record it to your drive. So in post, you could have it transcribed. And speaking of transcription, there's another great tool called otter.ai, which you can download for your phone or tablet or use it through their web interface. And it allows you to, I believe, translate or transcribe up to 30 minutes for free per month. And then they have a monthly or yearly plan, which isn't that expensive. And it allows you then to transcribe your webinars or your Zoom meetings. Zoom has a great feature. If you're on their middle tier or higher, you can actually just hit the button and it will automatically provide the recorded conferences that you've had, along with transcription. And if everyone's signed in with their Zoom account, it'll actually say, Nick said, Brent said, and so on. So it makes it really great. And what's really cool is if you click in the transcript, it'll take you to that part of the session. So you don't have to be like, oh, what was happening in that part? Or what was the program they were showing? Or what was the stakeholder telling us that we can't do?
hyperlinks directly to like a tag right in the video, a marker.
Exactly. Nice. Exactly. Yeah. So that makes life easier when you have to track stuff.
And I'd like to know how people are using, I mean, besides just the obvious of being able to make that kind of coolness available, I'd ask the chat, or if you know of any really good case studies of people actually applying this in their workplace and what kind of results they're getting and if people are liking it and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, that's a great question. We use it just about every day, even for internal meetings where we're talking or brainstorming about an idea. If someone can't make it to a meeting, especially now that everyone's remote and have crazy schedules with kids and so on, we pop it into the Slack channel so that everyone can kind of pop in and grab it as needed and refer back to it. Makes life a lot easier and you don't have to keep repeating yourself. Like, what did we talk about? I don't know. Check the transcript.
Yeah, great. Cool.
I'm just thinking of some of our planning calls and stuff that people might see how tangential we get on things, but maybe not a bad idea either.
Yeah, well, it makes it a lot easier for to cut out all the chit chat, right? It's just jump to the good stuff, right, to the meat of the conversation, and in that particular thing. All right. It doesn't look, let's see. Kara says, my work tends to involve asynchronous videos and audio. I'm falling in love with TextMiss Audio to get me started with CCs. Closed captions, pretty easy to edit and to port to Camtasia for an even easier editing. Yep, there you go.
Mm-hmm. Very cool. I have not used that one yet. So yeah. Put that on the list.
Heather's noting that they use it with client discovery calls. I'm presuming like the transcripting and stuff, etc. So
that's crazy.
Jennifer's noting her partner used it to compile highlights and quotes from SME interviews into a report. So there you go, too. Maybe your pen doesn't have to be constantly running, and it might allow you to actually more focus on the person-to-person stuff and start, oh, hold that thought. I got to write that down.
Yeah, the technology is making not just the creation of the learning content that we create as professionals easier. It's making that the process, the logistics of what we do a lot easier in getting that information and the transcription stuff, all of that. It just keeps getting better and better. It's really fun. And all of these tools help us in so many different ways. What do you got next for us? These are some good
I'm going to hit share screen. That's okay.
Yep. Go for it.
And one of my favorite new toys we've been using in the last several months is called Miro, M-I-R-O. And what it allows you to do is basically build a board of ideals or brainstorming. So a lot of times what we do is like starting to plan out what some of the toys we might show today. Brent was mentioning earlier that you can basically zoom out and kind of see the whole wall. And what's great about this tool is we're going to take a chance here. I'm going to share with everybody, and I'll pop that into the chat. And what's cool is actually we'll give you all editing rights. We're going for it. So I'm going to pop that into the Slack channel. And if you guys click that link, what it'll allow you to do is it'll open up Miro on your browser, and it'll actually let you come in, and we'll see everyone start to populate here. And what they can do is actually add their own toys. I know Kara mentioned the Audiate, I believe it was. So you can actually pop that onto the board. And what's really cool is that you have all your tools on the left-hand side, so I can just click on a sticky, and I can grab like a green sticky and pop it over here. So I'm just going to make a note that I want to come in. But I love doing this with a team. You can see that as a paid member, I can open it up to the world, and we see all those little cursors moving around. Mm-hmm. And I just like to sit back and watch everyone do their thing. It's a lot of fun. But what's really cool too is that you can take whatever you do and you can download it as a PDF, which makes it really great after a meeting to share. What we'll often do is as we're going like day to day through a project, we'll start to conceptualize ideals or storyboards, and we might use a program like Illustrator, Photoshop, Adobe XD, whatever it might be, and or just a sketching tool, and we'll grab those objects and pop it in here. So if I take a screen grab over here of us and the chat, I can grab that and just drop it in over here on the right, and you'll see it's starting to download or pull in. And then I can resize it and say, hey, here's our live cast. I grab this off the Twitter stream. Tim is in the house. Thank you, Tim. So it's really cool to help do it. And what I find is that as you start to do this, it's just organic, where people will start to move or help out, organize stuff. So like if we're brainstorming about an idea, I'll ask everyone to add their favorite tool to the board. And then people start to move things around. So like, oh, here's two audio programs, here's two video programs. So it's very cool just to see that interaction. Even more so like when you're in a physical room, because you got to move around people, because everyone can, you know, move their mouse around. What's really great also is that you can go in and bring in through your tablet or your phone. It also works through an app. And what's nice is that you can download for free that app, and you can play with up to three projects. And then as you start to use it, I believe it's about $200 per year, which isn't much money. And I did a feedback loop with them, and I'm like, you guys could add another zero on there and I'd be okay with it. And I was like, but please don't. Yes. But it's really cool to see all this stuff that they're doing in the program. And they have hundreds of templates. So if you're doing like a user story or a journey, you can start to use their templates to map out. There's a mind map tool. So it's really cool when you're conceptualizing or planning or demonstrating. There's some really cool stuff you can do too. So if I want to bring everyone to me, I'll make everyone upset. I can say, bring everyone to me, and they'll all come to my part of the screen now. You'll see all their cursors come to me, and then you guys can go free now. but that helps you to manage, and I'm going to ask everyone to be cool with what they're putting in the boards. I see some YouTube videos popping up. What's also really cool is that there's all kinds of plugins. So we use Asana as a project management tool internally, and we're able to bring up a board, but I can also search for a visual. So I like to use rubber ducks working with kids. So I can grab a duck and grab them, and you've got to make sure you have the rights to it, but I'm going to pretend I do. So then you can grab that visual and reposition it on screen. So as you're brainstorming or thinking about, wouldn't it be great if we had a brick wall or a picture of a lake? You can do a search all within the tool and start to move those elements around. And then someone actually figured out you can start to connect things. So you can show this is connected to that. And one of my favorite things to do is you can actually go in and draw. So there's a pencil tool, and if you're using it on your tablet, it's very organic. So that was my best impression of you guys. I hope you like your shirts. And I was doing that real quick last night. And
That's great.
It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. And
That definitely captured the COVID hair, that's for sure.
Yeah, it's like I almost have enough hair now to like I don't not as bald. I was like, whoa.
Kim's asking in the questions panel, are the internet imports dynamic, meaning are they screenshots or embeds?
Great question. So you can actually do it both ways. You can embed a link, which will open up a new window. And someone actually figured out that you can embed you can have it automatically do a screenshot of the URL. So if you have a course, or if you have, I think Kara probably pulled in the audio program, I can put that over here in media, and then you can resize it. And these are basically grabs of different things that I have in my presentation deck. But you can also bring in GIFs, or you can link to videos. So some things you can embed within a window, and some things you jump out of the browser window. But it's so inspiring / opening up. Like, it really helps when you're doing collaborative meetings. And I've done a couple fun things in the last 2 months since we've been in-house, where you can actually invite people in and they start creating stuff. And it's just so cool to see everyone get it within seconds and start to build stuff.
Very cool.
A lot of fun.
Frictionless is so critical in so many of these tools.
Yeah, guys, just one click entry, one click exit, one click to do what they need to do. If you have to explain too many things, that's when you start to lose everybody. But so there's a lot of media on here, and it doesn't seem to be lagging or slowing at all on my end. If I'm looking at it in a different browser while I'm obviously streaming to Crowdcast, I can still see everything moving around really smoothly. And when I try to drag and move something, it works fine. I can still zoom. I mean, that's pretty impressive.
Yeah, what's cool is that they used to call it a limitless board. And I've noticed in the last 2 or 3 weeks, there was an update, and now you can't pan out as far. But if you start to move an object further towards the edges, you can pan out farther. So it's very Yeah, it's kind of fun. I haven't pushed it to its limits. We did find one bug after swearing how much we love the product. like, this is the best thing ever. On the iPad, you can write very freely with the pencil. So if you write too much, it like bogs down the system. Like we had, I think, 3 weeks of notes that we wrote out and didn't like all those little objects because it converts them to little obtainable or movable things. So we had to archive some of them. But they're working on it. So it's like, oh, so cool. so yeah, some people found different links. Too cool. Another great program to kind of move in. So that's my favorite tool from a collaboration standpoint. I think everyone should play and try it out. There's another one, to be fair to the world, called Mural, M-U-R-A-L.com, and works in a similar way. We enjoyed Miro more because of the ability to work with graphics, and they kind of been overlapping. Mural had more tools for facilitators to be able to move people around. But in the last several weeks, since everyone's been in-house, they've been pumping out upgrades, and you now have like a timer, you have a voting feature, you have that ability to bring everyone towards you. You also have that ability to open it up to people that aren't paid members, which is great when you're collaborating because you don't want to pay for everyone. Like, you know, if it's an external team or another department, you want them to pay for you. Like, please buy our thing. So very cool.
Well, the thing that I like about a tool like this, and people have been dropping some alternatives in there that there are other, like somebody mentioned that MS Whiteboard kind of does the same thing or whatnot. But the thing that's nice about it from a practical standpoint is it makes it a lot easier than just like when you're in the middle of a meeting and you're like, oh yeah, let me send you that URL, and you drop it in an email, and then you know, someone's like, hold on, let me open my email and check it. Oh, it hasn't come through yet. Oh yeah, I don't see it yet. Oh, I sent it to the wrong email, you know, and all that kind of stuff. When you're in an environment like this, it's like, oh, let me show that to you. You know, grab a quick screen capture and just drag and drop, paste it right into here. There it is. Or the URL, bang, drop it in there. Nothing for them to click on. It's just the URL window, boom, pops up, and they can see what's going on there. Like you said, you can embed it or you can paste it or whatever. Yeah, it just like everything visually when you're having, especially virtually, right? When you're having these conversations, it's like if you walked into a meeting with the old briefcase and you had all the stuff as paperwork and you needed to show somebody something, you actually showed it to them. You know, you pull it out of your briefcase and go, oh, here's exactly what it looks like. This is what I drew. This is what it is, you know. And now we can all do that virtually, which is really super cool.
Yeah, one crazy other feature, they actually have built-in video conferencing, which we use Slack and Zoom mostly internally. But you can actually start a cast or an audio chat. So if I see that you're working on the same board, I can be like, hey, how you doing? And we can you know, start to open that up and even see each other. But like you said too, it's great because I might be working on the design aspect where you're working on the tech aspect or the marketing aspect, and we can all be simultaneously doing stuff and then kind of review, like, what do you think? And how do I want to do that? But it's a great way to open up the dialogue. If you guys want to be really daring, I can get out of my chair. there's a feature in Miro where it will actually take a picture of stickies. So behind me, I have a sticky wall of like where we have the physical board. And if I capture that within the app, it'll give us stickies that we can actually then reposition. So it will take a photo, but it will automatically recognize the two inch by two inch sticky note and allow you then to reposition them. It'll even do writing to text transcription. So you can actually edit it, which is crazy insane. We'll try it at the end.
I have a friend who's going to love this. And I'm certain she's one of the people that has probably never heard of these tools yet, because she is a very, very intense user of sticky notes on sticky paper that she puts all the big pages on the wall, and we brainstorm, or you know, and she that is like her shtick. She loves it, loves markers, the whole nine yards. I know there are a lot of you in the chat smiling right now because you're the same way, but yeah, let's step everybody up into the digital world of doing the same thing. But just like after a whole session of doing it in a room, if you were in a room with people, you'd taken that picture and then being able to do the drag and drop part and move things around. That is really slick.
Yeah.
Man, well, we could probably spend all day just on this tool. let's divvy up our time. What else you got for us?
Another great resource to keep inspired. There's a great blog called sidebar.io. And what this one allows you to do is basically keep up with what's happening from a creative standpoint. So every day they post 5 articles that they've curated, and they do an amazing job. You'll never be dissatisfied. So there's one about how this was created, or this week there were several on the Apple announcements that happened at the WWDC conference, virtual conference. But what's great is that they can automatically email you if you opt in, or you go to the site once a day, once a week, whenever you have time. But even if you go once a month, you can kind of go back through all these different articles to get inspired. And it's just such great data if you're looking for a break or an idea on how we can do this or that. Great place to, you know, curate or grab content to share, or just kind of refresh your brain with, wow, I need some inspiration. I've been working on this project for 3 days straight. Help me. it's all free, nice. Which is really cool. Another one also, there's a company called Envision App, which makes some great prototyping tools, but they have a blog similar to what, from a design creative standpoint called Inside Design. And they do some really great things where they'll do a video with different creative people from around the world, from big companies, from small companies, from game companies, but great place, again, just to get refreshed, inspired outside of our world. But again, just having that access. And then my favorite tool is feedly.com, which basically is a curation tool where you say, I love learning, education, training, business, whatever your favorite things are, and it will curate that content. And it's free. You can get it for your phone, your tablet, your computer, through the web browser. On your phone or tablet, there's an app that you can download similar to Flipboard. They've been introducing new features. So they have the free tier, and then they have paid tiers. And the paid tier, they have now AI built in. So as it learns what you like, it's really smart, and it will summarize an article. It will automatically highlight things that you should pay attention to. So when you have that 10-minute article and you've got 2 minutes before your next meeting, it's a great way to, you know, kind of skim or figure out, hey, here's 3 things I need to do. If we're working as a team, we can be sharing that same article so we can talk about it before you guys do your broadcast. And if you're throwing it up on the blog or something, you can, you know, swap notes. So it's a really good way. They also have a built-in newsletter feature, so it'll take whatever you've curated and automatically blast that out to whoever you've added to the list. And it runs about $200 a year. That seems to be the magic number, about $20 a month.
Feedly? Feedly is a paid app now?
To get the additional features. You can get all the base level free, and it works amazing. But Feedly will, if you want the AI and you want that automatic summarization or the collaboration components. So they're all looking way to scale up.
Yeah, it's one of the last remaining original RSS feed readers. Remember back in the day?
Yes. Shows our age.
And that's how I started using Feedly, was when Google Reader was sidebarred. And I switched over to Feedly, but I only use it, basically as an RSS feeder. And then I just scan stuff and things that I do want to read later and or might want longer than that, I save them straight from Feedly into Pocket. So,
yes, I do the same thing.
Which is another great
minds think the same. Yes, I'm just stealing a URL here, and I will save that. And if this works correctly, use my Stream Deck, and I can copy this. So I think I did this right. So I'm going to pop into here. Oops, that didn't work. Where'd you go? Blink and copy. So I'm just going to share. If I do this right, copy. Duplicate, go to. Doesn't want to play nice. Can't talk and look at the camera and copy. You guys are really good at this. I want to make sure I spelled this right. Yes, I did. All right. So I just added to the chat another link, which will link to Paper, which is a Dropbox platform for collaborating and taking notes. But what's really cool about the platform is a lot of times when we don't have time, it's a great way to quickly share. So in that list, there are several of the products that we talked about. There's also a link to a PDF version of the deck, and you're able to quickly link out to all the different tools that are there. So it's another way to curate and share, and you can add grabs, you can add videos. But what's great is that you don't have to go through an upload process. You just drag and drop, kind of like we're doing in Miro, and then you can copy a link, you can limit it to a certain team, but then you can pop it out to everyone. And it does require you to have a Dropbox account, which is also free, I believe up to 2 gigs, 5 gigs, somewhere in there. And then you can pay for it.
Dropbox accounts.
You still have, it doesn't, right?
Yeah, emails that say, you should pay us now to upgrade because you can't add any more stuff.
Right, right. You have to like put your other accounts in so you get more space for free. But also like around that $100 price mark, you get, I think it's 100 gigs now, a terabyte of space. Yeah. But we use that for our team. So here at the office, I'm using a MacBook with lots of monitors. And then at home, I have a laptop. But using Dropbox, I'm able to, you know, run home on the bike and not have to carry the physical device or carry a USB stick or something. And it's always synced to where I am at, which nice. I love. Yeah.
Dang, this list of tools is epic.
Yeah. For those that still like to read, I listen to audiobooks, but three that really inspired me in the last year, Creativity Inc. by Ed Catmull, who is one of the founders of Pixar, when they first started as a technology guy. Really epic book where it talks about some of the stories and some of the challenges they ran into. I believe it was Toy Story 2 or 1, where the hard drives crashed that had stored all the content, and they would have lost, I think, 6 months of work, but someone was on leave and had a copy of the data. I believe she just had her baby, and but she was still reviewing and looking at content dailies, so they only lost a day. But just to hear those things that you think only happened to you, it's just so cool and so amazing to hear how they, you know, almost went out of business several times, and now they're part of, you know, they brought Disney back to life of what, you know, what's possible as the animation king, queen, which is really cool. I'm a Disney fan, if you haven't noticed.
I love stories like that. I just have to interject this because I was blown away when I heard the story of Spielberg when he was making Jaws and all of the roadblocks and issues and problems and things that happened. Like at one point they had, because they were old-fashioned film, apparently he had dropped it in the ocean in the salt water. And so they had to figure out a way to clean all, because they couldn't reshoot a whole entire roll of film and whatnot. And so they had to figure out a special way to make it not ruin the shots. And I mean, like all of the things. And it's like you listen to it or you read the book of experiences like that and you think, yeah, that would have crushed me. I would have just called it quits. You know, the reason why really great epic movies and epic projects like happen and become epic is they just keep pounding on it and they just keep pushing up against all of those tragedies that happen along the way. It's just always incredible to read.
Yes. Yes. You get inspiration, you get ideas, you get to share it. Great way just to keep it going.
Very cool.
The other book is really cool is Robert Iger, who kind of is responsible for Disney buying Lucasfilms, Star Wars, Marvel, as well as Pixar, tells and shares his story of how he kind of reinvented Disney and, you know, helped to move it around globally. Just really cool, really seems like a really good guy, and talks about some of the things that he experienced starting really, you know, at an entry level at ABC and kind of worked his way up. And, you know, you would never think that would happen, but just so cool. Inspirational again. See what's possible. So we'll jump out here. One thing I want to share is if, especially when everyone's working at home now, and I know a lot of us have to move from the one room to the other. I was mentioning earlier, I have a 9-year-old and a 15-year-old, so they pretty much dominate or have control of the house. I just go where they let me go. I do have one little corner, though, where I have two monitors plugged into my computer. And what's great is that if you have a Mac or PC laptop, it's so easy now and so inexpensive, like for about $150, you can get a super large screen and it just allows you to spread out. So as you're working on your favorite toys and tools, it allows you to help, you know, move those things, those windows around and make it easier to play.
Mm-hmm.
So really cool.
It's such a, it makes such a difference in your efficiency. When all of this hit, I was set up to work at home and I ended up going back to the office about 2 weeks into all of this. And the thing I did was I grabbed the big monitor that I had in my office. I had a second monitor in my at home already, but I was like, no, I want those extra few inches because it makes such a huge difference in getting things done for sure. Yeah. Yeah. As Craig's noting, if you can find them in stock and all kinds of challenges with yeah. things still. So, yeah. Before we forget, I wanted to throw, Sierra from our team is going to throw a link in, cause speaking of free, our Domino team, our Domino creative team, our content team has put together a collection of COVID-19 related graphics that we're offering to anybody who wants those. So Sierra has popped a URL in there where you can just pop to our website, sign up, the email will come to you with the link to download them. There are more than 4,700 images in total in the collection, sort of a base set and then color variations and stuff. Our team really knocked it out of the park on that. So we're offering them free to anybody who's, you know, got to do COVID related training or can make use of them in your organization, etc. And you know, they're Creative Commons licensed. And so Sierra's popping that in. And the big thing again is the word free. You can go and grab those. And I'm noticing Shannon's note. Shannon, they're actually also in your Domino One site. We actually have uploaded them as well to the stock art collection in Domino One sites. So you can find them there.
Yep. You already
did
it.
Yep. Shannon's got it already, with her team. So
that's awesome.
Yeah. They're, transparent PNGs. So they should work in lots of contexts, you know, even if it's not e-learning specifically, it's PowerPointy or what have you. Shannon, if you go to our community site, we do have an article up there on where to find them, because a lot of people have not even navigated to the stock collections very often. So there is an article in the community site, community.domino.com, that for Domino One users help you find them within the tool set itself. But if you're not a client, just use the link that Sierra posted in and download them and use them. And we'd also love to know how you ended up using them. If they were helpful, et cetera, let us know. And we'd like to know that that they help you do sure. good things. Yeah.
What else? Do you got a couple more before we wrap it up here, Nick?
Yes. Another great app. If you're working with your phone or your tablet, there's a app for Mac or Windows called Reflector. And it's by a company called Squirrels. Being an animal company, we like that too. But what it allows you to do is mirror your phone or your tablet back to your computer and allows you to record it. So if I do this correctly, and if you guys peek at my screen, I've got my iPad with iOS, whatever the beta is now, and you guys can actually see in real time what I'm doing. Yeah. But some of the really cool new features that are coming into iOS are these new widgets, so you can actually control and resize and hide apps. There's a new search, there's a new Siri. My kids are really excited because when they get a call on their tablet, it takes over the full screen, and now that'll become a small notification, which is kind of cool, so that you don't have to you know, stop playing your game. You got an extra minute there in between meetings. one of the really cool things that you can do in the tool is using the pencil. You can actually start to write. So I studied engineering in school, so that automatically made my writing not that good. Chris, and I can't talk and write. always fun to see. And what's really cool is that if I bring up my tool set, I can grab that copy. And we'll, of course, in the demo, it probably won't work. But if I touch it, I can say copy as text. So it will automatically take my scribble and rewrite it. And what's really cool is if you're using a writing program or another product, here you can see some notes I was taking last night. You see a little illustration that I drew. I was highlighting some text and things that were in there. But if I hit the return key here, I can just come in and paste. And there's, didn't spell Brent right. I got to make my N a little better. But you can see that it pulls it in. So you, as you're taking notes, you can highlight different things, you can draw, and really cool how you can kind of put those things together.
So the reflector is the tool that lets you actually, in this case, share what's on your iPad into something like a video session like this, or onto your desktop to share it. I think it's what Nuggethead was using last week for the drink and draw, Kevin Thorne. That's how he was using his iPad to then display it for us. But I think the writing thing that you were just showing, that's it, part of the new iOS for iPad, right?
Exactly. That'll be later this fall.
Yeah.
And it's just hand recognition. Yeah, handwriting recognition.
Yeah, cool. Actually, and it's actually iPad OS. It's a new version of the OS that they're using. So it's not just regular iOS. It's specifically an OS for the iPad.
Yes. I haven't gotten that programmed in my brain yet.
At some point, it's just going to be OS, I think. I think they got to merge them all at some point, but I think they're getting closer, but who knows?
Yeah,
very cool.
While we're in this mode, Feedly, we were mentioning earlier, so this is the paid tier, but there's a AI technology they call Leo. So it automatically pulls out of the 1,000 articles that I have curated for this week. It automatically pulls several that it thinks are a priority for me to see based on my preferences. And then if I select an article, it will go in. You can see that highlighting that's there. And, it helps me to then share that or communicate that or, see from this long 11-minute article all the things that I might want to grab or share. One of my other really favorite features of using the iPad is that if you grab the corner and drag inwards with your pencil, you get to automatically, kind of like a built-in Snagit. They call it markup. So this is really great. If you're working on a program or you see a site, you can go in and highlight or draw. So I can grab the red and say, hey guys, I need you to make this smaller, swap images. But then you can quickly share that. So I can bring that back to my computer. I can email it or text it. There's mom and the little ones. But it makes it really easy to quickly share and move stuff around, especially when you're jumping in and out of meetings or you're moving around. Helps keep life straight.
Very cool.
Yeah, for sure. Dang it, we're pushing up against our max allotted time limit here today. But you've shared the lists, you've shared the URLs with everybody in the chat there. If you guys have missed it, you can scroll back through and you can pick up some of these links and find all that stuff. Nick, where can people find you if they're like, I don't want the link. I want to go right to the source.
You can find me on Twitter, just Nick Floro, and feel free to email as well. I'll type that into the chat.
Very cool.
I think you guys tweeted it out as well.
Everybody should know Nick Floro. Come on. If you don't, if you haven't met him yet, you must. Thanks for doing this with us, Nick. Man, you and I have done other shows and whatnot, but we just have never had a chance to get you on Idiotic. So it's been great to have you here today. Thanks.
Yeah, this has been a lot of fun. You can see the goosebumps happening in the chat. Ooh, which is always the best part of what we get to do here. So, well, that and dancing. Dancing is the other best part of what we get to do.
Where's my character?
Yes.
Indeed it is. Ah, yes. Yes.
My character, sorry.
Sometimes
I said I can only dance when I have a baby. So this is my prop.
Do you find yourself ever standing still and just swaying because for no reason? It's just like because you did it when you were holding the kids. I do it all the time on my way.
I also make sound effects. So as I'm moving my mouse around, I'm like, whoosh, whoosh. Makes it a lot more fun to do your work. It's that same mental state.
Yeah.
Oh,
we love it. Lovely. All right. Well, gang, thanks for joining us this week, as always. We'll let you dance into the rest of your Wednesday, and we'll see you guys next week.
Yeah, next week I'll be flying solo, right? You're going to take a little vacation.
Next week is Canada Day, so I'll be off Canada-ing.
Off Canada-ing? Perfect.
Canada-ing.
I'll be chatting with Nyla Spooner, who was with us for a longer session about the racial justice and the intersection with LND a few weeks back, if you guys want to listen to that. But Nyla will be with me, and we'll be having a great conversation about the work that she's doing. So, good times.
Excellent. Thanks everybody.
Ciao.
Stick around for that last great special effect.
Here it comes.
Oh yeah, there we have it.
It's the slow-mo version.
Try to grab it.
Talk to everybody later. Thanks, gang.
Bye, everyone. Have a great